Rejoice, daughters of Zion. See, your king comes to you seated on a donkey, on a donkey's colt, bringing salvation. Rejoice in this Palm Sunday. I order services before you. The cross will process into the church. Please stand. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Beloved in the Lord, let us draw near with a true heart and confess our sins unto God our Father, beseeching the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to grant us forgiveness. Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
I said I will confess my transgressions unto the Lord. Almighty God, merciful Father, I, a poor, miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserve your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and sincerely repent of them. And I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death, of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor, sinful being. Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office, as a called and ordained servant of the word, announce the grace of God on all of you. And in this stand, and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We sing the words of our introit, we sing the bold. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, you sent your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, to take upon himself our flesh and to suffer death upon the cross. Mercifully grant that we may follow the example of his great humility and patience and be made partakers of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated. The Old Testament lesson for Palm Sunday is Deuteronomy, the 32nd chapter. The Lord will vindicate his people and have compassion on his servants. He will see that their power is gone and there is none remaining, bond or free. Then he will say, where are their gods, the rock in which they took refuge, who ate the fat to their sacrifices and drank the wine of drink offering? Let them rise up, help in you. Let them be your protection. See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God beside me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. And there is none that can deliver out of my hand. This is the word of the Lord. The epistle lesson is from Philippians, the second chapter. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, although he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but made himself nothing, taking the form of a servant. Being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself in becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on the cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and has bestowed upon him the name that is above every name. So the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 12th chapter. The next day, the large crowd that had come to the feast heard that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem. So they took branches of palm trees and went out to meet him, crying out, Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, even the King of Israel. And Jesus found a young donkey and sat on it, just as is written, Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt. His disciples did not understand these things at first. But when Jesus was glorified, then they remembered that these things had been written about him, and he had done to him. The crowd that had been with him when he called Lazarus out of the tomb raised him from the dead, continued to bear witness. The reason why the crowd went to meet him was that they heard he had done this sign. So the Pharisees said to one another, "You see that you are gaining nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." This is the gospel of the Lord. We confess the Christian faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ,
the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate.
grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Jesus enters triumphantly with cheers into Jerusalem. He receives a hero's welcome. But this is not a sponsored citywide event. This is a ragtag, grassroots, last-minute effort. But our Lord does get his due as a king, as he should. Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, even the King of Israel. He is truly Lord, bearing God's name. But unlike most kings, he is not on a tall, proud animal. Instead, Jesus fulfills the Holy Scripture spoken through Zechariah the prophet. Fear not, daughter of Zion. Behold, your king is coming, sitting on a donkey's colt. This king comes in slightly ridiculous fashion, riding a lowly donkey. And a crowd of foreign out-of-towners there for the Passover hear the news of Jesus raising Lazarus from the dead. And so Jesus rides to expand his kingdom, to obtain glory for us. He does not come as someone better than us, lording it over us. Jerusalem has the temple, has the prestige, it has the reputation. But this is not a royal place of rest for Jesus. Instead, it is the locale of death. For Jerusalem is the rebellious, murderous son, continually rejecting God and his word. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. It is the place of rejection, of suffering. And we praise Jesus today because he entered for us, not to get glory for himself, but to give his glory through the shedding of his own innocent blood. Jesus is kingly and stately, but he is riding to his death for sinners. The Lamb of God riding a young male donkey to take away the sins of the world. So Jesus is not a conquering hero coming back from war, getting the praise after the fact. He's entering the battle. He is going towards the cross that will be his death. But our king is not like other kings. He does not demand and take. He enters in humble, lowly fashion to show that he will give himself. He will be the sacrifice, his own life, for all people. Even those who do not praise his entry, even those who do not notice or give him his due. For he goes to die for the leaders who organize his execution, for the soldiers who carry it out, for the hateful and ungodly of all times, for those who resist him and his lordship. He does this out of love, even those for those who will shout, "Crucify him, crucify him." For Jesus is entering the fight. He is facing death once for all to take away its pall for us, to deliver all imprisoned by sin, all people of all times and all places. So don't fear. Jesus comes not to intimidate you or to show he is better than you, but to give you his goodness. He goes to fight Satan, not the people who are enslaved by him, nor the corrupt rulers. Jesus fights the source and dominion of evil. And that is what you are freed from by Jesus' one righteous act. For Jesus is completely unlike other kings and rulers of this world. He does not demand tribute. Instead, he gives you what you lack from himself. He does not need your glory, your praise, your vote of confidence. Rather, he gives you his own righteousness straight from heaven. So Scripture says, you will be enriched in every way, to be generous in every way, which through us will produce thanksgiving to God. Christ becomes like us so that we would be like God, generous and rich in divine gifts. For this king is selfless, not putting himself ahead of others, but below us. The king of all things became your sacrifice. And so he is the only leader that we can submit fully to that results in peace, freedom, and joy in God himself. And so we should praise Jesus like a little child, because he is above all earthly things. He marched to rescue us from death. For this place, Golgotha, right outside Jerusalem, was marked from eternity as our spot of salvation. Jesus rides to our death, a death for all wrongdoing, for all your sins. And so he is to be welcomed as our Savior, who died but is alive. But what kind of king do you expect? What kind of kingdom do you seek? The world knows only of power, pride, dominance, and oppression, and slavery. Everything is a tug of war of give and take. Sinners butting heads. There are only winners and losers in the world's kingdoms. But not in God's kingdom. You are called out of being jealous of others' power. Follow Jesus in meekness to another way, a way of peace and love. Observe his example. For Jesus does not exercise his privilege and lord it over others. He lays it aside so that he could be treated as a criminal. For he is convicted and condemned, but he's not fight back. He does not say how unfair it is. No, he does it out of love for us. For in doing so, our Lord became our sin and our death, putting an end to all our guilt. And so you are freed by this king. Hold fast to this word of life. Follow him by doing all things without grumbling, without disputing. For you have a way of peace in Jesus that he opened up. The king of all lowered himself to be your servant, to care for your needs, to lift up the powerless and the weak. And in Christ, we have all of God's love. And so the way of truth is not about pleasing ourselves, getting our own way, acting as a vain tyrant. No, we are to look to the needs of others, to treat others as we would like to be treated. So you are called to forgive others, even if they have rejected you and treated you unfairly. You do this by following the King. This is how you show you follow him, by loving as he has loved you. But people often treat Jesus like an earthly ruler, demanding things of him, a better job, a more pleasant family, better living conditions, the same things that people expect of our civil government, treating that as if it were God, to take care of all their needs and every problem that could possibly come up, as if they're gods. But civil authorities do not control all things on earth. They have a very limited duty under God to keep peace and order among sinners. They may print money, but they do not create goodness. They do not publish peace. They do not increase love by passing new laws. Rather, they give and take. They know only power and force, creating nothing. But not Christ. He is the true king. He is our true governor, the governor of our soul. And he shows his concern by offering the ultimate gift, himself, God, given for you. But yet note well that God is not your bread king. Jesus is not your sugar daddy. He's not interested in being your co-pilot. Jesus is truly king, head and Lord of all things, above every prince and authority. And so Jesus did not come to fix your earthly difficulties, to resolve your dilemmas, to make every difficult decision for you. Now, Jesus gives you your daily bread, even though you don't deserve it, but he does not take orders. A prayer is not a demand. So don't mistake Jesus' lowly ride in humility for weakness. He is still God, the one who created all things. But God debases himself in this one way for your salvation, to glorify you, to give you power to live in righteousness set apart from the world. So he is to be your king, to rule in your mind, in your heart. His obedience to death was necessary to save you, and this is what he gives. The God of the universe riding a humble creature of work, a burden, a beast of burden. The Son of God became man to save you from your sin, to give you a new life in him, to live in righteousness. We see the strength of our King in his humility as he was facing his earthly demise. We see that God is not too proud to ride a donkey, to be celebrated by outcasts, to bleed and to die. Our Lord does not demand star treatment. He did not ask for the key to the city of Jerusalem. Instead, he boldly offers his blood to offset all sins, fulfilling the divine payment plan to buy you back. And it is only in this sacrifice for sins, made by the holy flesh of God, that wins you. The Son gives up his lofty perch to be a meek and humble Savior so that you would know his true power. He is humble. God is humble to suffer for us, taking our condemnation and restoring us to the Father. And so we have every reason to praise him. Hosanna. The King did it himself. Our King is now our life. How do we welcome Jesus today? Not by paying taxes, not by doing civic works, not by carrying palm branches around with you 24/7, but by depending on his weakness for you. We appropriate his death in baptism. We eat and drink his righteousness by faith. For he is the self-giving King who comes to sinners. And so we are to repent. We know the Almighty God only as dying, lowly and cursed. Jesus put under the yoke for all the disobedient, and he was humble and obedient to death for your sake, so that you would be brought into his kingdom. And citizenship in this spiritual kingdom is not by natural birth. Your family connections and history are irrelevant to Jesus. He gives you spiritual birth by the Word, by the water, giving us his Spirit to live in us. We are made alive by the Word of the King who conquered Satan. And Christ comes to us today so that we receive him as our true King. But Jesus does not come in fancy duds or long processions or earthly glory. Jesus comes, mostly ignored, in the news of victory, in the news of his riding to Calvary. And just like Jesus' march into Jerusalem, today Jesus is easily dismissed among the hustle and bustle of this world. For Jesus is not the King that sinners who are proud demand. He does not come to fill your entertainment calendar or your bank accounts. He does not heal on command or send you a monthly benefit check. Rather, we suffer with Christ We wait for death to be laid aside. For we get to journey with Jesus as he calls us along to heaven, riding humbly and patiently through our suffering to death to be raised with him. And so if he is our king, we may not follow our natural desires, the things that flow from our sinful hearts. We are to follow this king so that he will be king of our will. His death is not just to be praised and lauded from afar. It is to be participated in. We actually follow him in dying to sin. That is why you are baptized into the death of Jesus, to die and live with him. But naturally, we want the wrong kind of leader. We want a leader who will do what we want. We think only of the fleshly things of this world, things that are easy and nice and pretty. Our hearts want to negotiate with God, offering him a trade. But God does not negotiate with enemies. But he does love his children, who are heirs through Christ. And so we are to turn to Jesus and not trust in our own power, not seek your own anyway, don't be your own king anymore. He wants all the nations to turn from pride in themselves and violence to be a part of his kingdom. So he calls you to humble yourself, to forsake dreams of earthly glory, to stop wanting praise from others. After all, the donkey is not a luxury ride. Don't expect better than our king right now. And we still follow our king, Christ, even through death, for he has faced it for us. And because of that, we are already forgiven and at peace with God, for Jesus did it in his body. And our Lord is not like an earthly leader making empty promises, but he is a spiritual life giver, making the dead alive to know God, to follow him. And so all praise is centered on his humble fulfillment of God's word, the Bible's prophecies, the one who died to make you alive. For Jesus comes into the holy city to enter the fray, to fight Satan and hell on your behalf. And this is the only victory we get to enjoy forever. Jesus fought for us. We didn't have to ask him. He faces the cross of shame alone. So don't be afraid to set your compass to righteousness, to follow Christ, even if it means you will suffer, be unpopular, if you will ride alone here on earth. For we are not truly alone, because our God knows unfair treatment. The King is with us. For Jesus comes today to bring righteousness and salvation with him. And we live by these gifts, and so we are to see our sin and our death upon Christ. He took them. He carried them like a donkey. And he is our true king in all things, even above the mighty civil leaders. Faith in him supersedes all earthly powers. For Jesus governs us by his word, telling us what is God's will and guiding us to heaven. So rest securely in this king. Civil courts err, but not your ruler now on high. Trust in Jesus. Obey him in suffering. Do not turn aside from your cross. Do not be daunted by suffering. When Satan holds your sins up before you, Jesus carried them, working for you. We follow our Lord who rode to our death without grumbling, without blaming others, without saying this is unfair. He willingly took on your sins, bore your death, and so learn from him on how to live and how to die. Hosanna. The praise Jesus receives is fitting. But what he did was not for a reaction or for approval ratings. He did it for us, so that we would be received into his kingdom and rejoice in salvation. For he is the real king, opening heaven to all who turn away from their sin. He rides into our hearts today to give us his kingdom. All hail King Jesus, who is our King. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Prayers of the church, please stand. Let us pray for the whole church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, out of your love for sinners, you have gifted us your one and only Son, high and lifted up on the cross, crucified and risen for the life of the world. Lord, in your mercy, Lord, your kingdom is unlike any kingdom of this world. Your kingdom is a kingdom of love and mercy, service and sacrifice. You serve your church with your holy word. Lord, in your mercy, rejoice that you have ushered us into your kingdom by water and the word, baptizing us and bringing the Holy Spirit, the gift of the forgiveness of sins. Lord, in your mercy, Lord, your example of humility and patience teaches your church how to live in the midst of suffering. We ask your blessings upon the family and friends of Zion, those who are suffering and those who are ill, for Dale, Larry, Dan, Terry, Anna, Noah, Caroline, and Janelle. Bless over your servants that as they bear their infirmities, they ever do so in faith and trust in you, praying, thy will be done. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Jesus is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. We ask your blessings upon our civil government, that they would serve in humility and kindness, serving for what is good and right, the life of a baby in the womb, the sanctity of human life, and the gift of marriage between a man and a woman. Give our earthly governments abilities to serve without corruption, but do what is right. Lord, in your mercy, let me ask your blessings upon our Holy Week celebration, the gift of Christ's passion, his riding in on a donkey, his crucifixion and his resurrection. Fill our hearts with joy by the gift of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Let me ask your blessings upon all those who come to your table this morning to receive the most holy and precious gifts of Christ's body to eat and blood to drink. May all those who come forward do so with a true faith, with a truly repentant heart, to receive the sacrament worthily in the fellowship of this altar. Lord, in your mercy, into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray. Trust in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our crucified and risen Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We continue with the service of the sacrament. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary. We should at all times and all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who accomplished the salvation of mankind by the tree of the cross, that where death arose, life also might rise again, and that where the serpent overcame by the tree in the garden, might likewise by the tree of the cross be overcome. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night in which he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." The same manner after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, gave it to him, saying, "Drink it of all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always. thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Let us pray. O God, the Father, the fountain and source of all goodness, who in loving kindness send your only begotten Son into the flesh, we thank you that for his sake you've given us pardon and peace in this sacrament. And we ask you not to forsake your children, but always rule our hearts and minds by your Holy Spirit, that we may be able to serve you constantly. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
Bless we the Lord. The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you, be gracious unto you, or lift up his countenance upon you, and give you his peace.
Amen.
May be seated.